Hello everyone. Today, we'll learn how to animate objects. In ActivePresenter, you can animate both annotation objects such as shapes and pictures, and interactive objects like questions and buttons. To add animation to an object, select it. Open the Animations tab, and select the animation type you want. There are four types of animation: effect, entrance, exit, emphasis, and motion path. Entrance effects and exit effects control how an object enters and exits a slide respectively. Some animation effect types have a set of effect options. For example, you can let the objects fly in from left, right, or bottom. However, some effects like fade in, fade out don't have further options. To view how the effects look like, you can click the preview button or press space. In addition, emphasis effects animate objects that are already on a slide. These effects make an object change its size, transparency, shake, or spin on its center. Along with emphasis, motion path effects move objects already in a slide along a predetermined path, like a line, circle, or a star. You can create a custom path to animate an object using the Custom Path option. Each motion path effect also comes with further options. For instance, you can let the object move along the circle shape, or a hexagon shape, depending on your want. The path of a motion is editable. However, we'll learn how to do that in another video, Editing Object Motion Path. Here are the effect time bars in the timeline pane. You can drag them to change their start time and duration. Alternatively, you can right-click the effect time bar, select Animation Settings to open the Settings dialog, and edit Effect Properties. You can also change the values in these sections to define the start time and duration. For the emphasis and motion path effect, you have the option to let them repeat until the slide duration ends. For that to happen, right-click the effect time bar, select Animation Settings. From the repeat list, select until end of slide. Bear in mind that you can also loop the motion path effects, making them automatically replay even when the slide duration is over. However, you have to do that in the interactive timelines. For more information about this, refer to the video, Creating and Using Multiple Timelines. In addition, if you want to apply an animation effect to all of the same object types in the working project, you can set the animation effect for one. Then, right-click that object on the canvas, click Apply to All Objects Type, and select Animation. Besides, to remove an animation effect, simply select it and press Delete. Or, you can drag its time bar downward. Keep dragging until it turns gray, and release the mouse button. Let's see how the animation we've created looks like. That's how you animate objects in ActivePresenter 7. Hope that helps. Thank you for watching.